Good evening children, this is Padma from GK Jain Schools. Let's continue with complex numbers from 12th maths. We'll be continuing with the same exercise only, that is exercise 2.4 and its related example sums also. Let's move on to the topic now. We shall continue with the next set of examples and its related exercise problems. These properties are very important, better go through them once again because we'll be using them in the sums. Let's move on to the sums now. Example 2.8, show that 2 plus I root 3 the whole power 10 plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10 is real, and 19 plus 9i by 5 minus 3i the whole power 15 minus 8 plus I by 1 plus 2i the whole power 15 is purely imaginary. So there are two subdivisions. This sum is actually frequently asked important 5 mark question. First we will see the first subdivision. Consider 2 plus I root 3 the whole power 10 plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10. So first we will name this as z is equal to 2 plus I root 3 the whole power 10 plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10. So just now we went through the properties. I told you once again you have to go through the properties because we will be making use of them in the sums. See, this is one of the property. Z is real if and only if z is equal to z bar. If I am able to prove that z is equal to z bar, then z has to be real. So that is one among the property. So using that property, we'll now start converting z as z bar. So z bar is equal to, I'll write this z with the bar, means I have to write the conjugate for this expression. So 2 plus I root 3 the whole power 10 plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10 the whole bar. Now we have one more property. Z1 plus Z2 the whole bar can be written as Z1 bar plus Z2 bar, means we can split the bar and write the term separately. Using that, I am going to write this as 2 plus I root 3 the whole power 10 the whole bar plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10 the whole bar. Again, there is one more property. If it is Z power n the whole bar, it can be written as Z bar the whole power n, interchanging the conjugate and the power. So using that, I will interchange this conjugate to the term and the power will be removed to the whole. That is 2 plus I root 3 the bar whole power 10 plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole bar whole power 10. So now using this property we have concluded this. Now what does this mean? 2 plus I root 3 the whole bar means I have to write the conjugate for this expression. So the conjugate for this will be replacing plus by minus, that is 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10 plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10 means the conjugate of this will be 2 plus I root 3 the whole power 10. Now what is this? We started with z bar, we started converting z bar from z, right? And we have ended up with, we got ended up with z. So z is equal to z bar, which means we have concluded, it is proved that 2 plus I root 3 the whole power 10 plus 2 minus I root 3 the whole power 10 is real. Now consider the second part. 19 plus 9i by 5 minus 3i the whole power 15 minus 8 plus I by 1 plus 2i the whole power 15. So first we'll name, let z is equal to the given expression. So this sum is like a little different compared to the previous sum. So first we'll write the property what we'll be using here. So to prove that, as per the question, we have to prove that this expression is purely imaginary. So the property is z is purely imaginary if and only if z bar is equal to minus z. That is, when I'm going to convert this expression as z bar, I should get z with the minus sign outside. Okay, so now we will check it off. First we will consider this expression 19 plus 9i by 5 minus 3i the whole power 15. That is, we will consider this and we will bring it to the rectangular form. So to bring it to this, to the rectangular form, I have to multiply and divide by the conjugate of the denominator, that is 5 plus 3i by 5 plus 3i. So we have seen this method enough in all the previous sums. First we will multiply the numerator, and in the denominator we will apply a plus b, a minus b, that is a square minus b square. So I am getting it to be 2 plus 3i, okay, which is nothing but I have taken 34 outside, I am getting it to be 2 plus 3i. And similarly, I will consider the next expression 8 plus I by 1 plus 2i. 8 plus I by 1 plus 2i means I have to multiply and divide by the conjugate. The conjugate of the denominator is 1 minus 2i. So 1 minus 2i by 1 minus 2i, and numerator we have to multiply. Denominator we can use a square minus b square formula, and here also I am getting it to be 2 minus 3i. See, the first expression I got it to be 2 plus 3i, and the second expression I have got it to be 2 minus 3i. Now this whole expression z will become we'll take the transformation as z is equal to 2 plus 3i the whole power 15 minus 2 minus 3i the whole power 15. So now I'm going to convert z bar. So I'll apply the bar here, and using this property z1 minus z2, the whole bar can be written as z1 bar minus z2 bar. So I will also split the bar here, and again using this property z power n the whole power n, the whole bar can be written as z bar the whole power n. So using that I'll split the bar here. So I have to write the conjugate of this. This will become 2 minus 3a and this will become 2 plus 3a. Now compare this z bar and z here. Here you are having minus sign in front of 2 minus 3a, and here in z bar you are having the minus sign in front of 2 plus 3a. So if I take the minus outside, this will become 2 plus 3a the whole power 15 minus 2 minus 3a the whole power 15, and this expression is nothing but z. So I have got z bar to be minus z, and hence proved that it is purely imaginary. So this is how you have to prove this. Exercise 2.4, sixth sum. Find the least value of the positive integer n for which this expression, that is root 3 plus I the whole power n, will become real and also purely imaginary. This is also very important 5 mark question. So first we will name this root 3 plus I in the polar form. We know rectangular form, that is x plus iy, and this is called polar form. We will see about this elaborately in the upcoming exercises. So I will write this as r into cos theta plus I sin theta, and I will name it as 1. This is called polar form. Okay. Now there is a condition that if a plus ib is equal to r of cos theta plus I sin theta, I can write r as root of a square plus b square. Now compare this a plus ib and root 3 plus I. Instead of a you are having root 3, instead of ib you are having, in the place of b you are having 1. So my r will become is equal to root of root 3 the whole square plus 1 the whole square, that is 3 plus 1 root 4. So r takes the value 2, and also we know that tan theta will take the value, because in polar form the theta will assign tan values only. So tan theta is equal to b by a. What is b here? B is 1 and a is root 3, so 1 by root 3. If tan theta is equal to 1 by root 3, what is theta? Tan inverse of 1 by root 3, that is pi by 6. Now we will substitute this theta in this expression, that is root 3 plus I is equal to r cos theta plus I sin theta. In the place of theta and in the place of r we will substitute. So this will become root 3 plus I is equal to 2 cos pi by 6 plus I sin pi by 6, and when I am taking the power n, this will become 2 power n cos pi by 6 plus I sin pi by 6 the whole power n. Now we are asked to find the least value of n, right? So I'll name this as 2. So this is by trial and error method only we have to check. We have to check from n 0, n equal to 0, n equal to 1, n equal to 2. Similarly we have to check. When I'm checking for n equal to 3, this 2 becomes, see here, root 3 plus I the whole power 3 is equal to 2, means in the place of n I'll substitute 3. So 2 power 3 cos, in the place of n I'll substitute 3, means 3 pi by 6 plus I sin 3 pi by 6. Now this 3 and 6 will get cancelled, making it to be cos pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2. What is cos pi by 2? Pi by 2 is 90 degree and cos 90 degree is 0, whereas sin 90 degree is 1. So I'm getting it to be 2 cube into I, and I indicates the imaginary. So we have concluded the least positive integer n equal to 3, n when taking the value 3, the expression becomes purely imaginary. Similarly by trial and error method, when I'm applying n equal to 6, 2 becomes 2 power 6 cos 6 pi by 6 plus I sin 6 pi by 6. 6 and 6 gets cancelled, means I'll get it to be cos pi plus I sin pi, and cos pi, cos odd pi will take the value minus 1, and sin pi is, I mean sin odd values become 0, so this will be 0. So 2 power 6 into minus I, which is minus 2 power 6. We need not find the value of 2 power 6 and all, but this is a real value, which means which is purely real and hence proved. So this is also very important sum. Now we will move on to the seventh sum in the exercise. See, this is very similar to the example sum we saw just before now, that is the example 2.8. I am doing the second subdivision because first subdivision is very easy. You can compare it with the example and do it. See the second subdivision, 19 minus 7i by 9 plus I the whole power 15 plus 20 minus 5i by 7 minus 6i the whole power 15 is real. Okay, first we will name, let z is equal to the given expression. Then we will consider this part alone. In the denominator I am having 9 plus I, so I have to multiply and divide by 9 minus I, 9 minus I, that is the conjugate of 9 plus I. Now I have to multiply the numerator, so I am getting this expression, and in the denominator I have to apply a plus b a minus b, that is a square minus b square. So I square is minus 1, minus into minus will become plus 1. So I am getting it to be 82 into 2 minus I by 82. 82, 82 will get cancelled. So 19 minus 7i by 9 plus I is 2 minus I. Now I will go for the second expression. 20 minus 5i by 7 minus 6i is equal to 20 minus 5i by 7 minus 6i into 7 plus 6i by 7 plus 6i. What is this 7 plus 6i? It is the conjugate of this denominator. So again, rationalizing, I am getting it to be, I will get the expression by multiplying, and the denominator I will apply a square minus b square. So this will become 49, 6 square is 36 and I square is minus 1. So 49 plus 36. So I am getting it as 170 plus 85i by 85. I am taking the 85 outside. 85, 85 gets cancelled. I am getting it to be 2 plus I. So for the first expression, I got it to be 2 minus I. And for the second expression, I am getting it to be 2 plus I. Now I will check. The question is, I have to prove that it is real. Okay. So to prove it is real, I have to show that Z is equal to Z bar. So now I will take, I will start with Z. I am applying the conjugate here. So I can split the conjugate by the property. Z1 plus Z2 the whole bar can be written as Z1 bar plus Z2 bar. And then the bar can be interchanged with the power using this property. Z power n the whole power bar can be written as Z bar the whole power n. So using that, I have to write the conjugate for this. So the conjugate of 2 minus I is 2 plus I. And the conjugate of 2 plus I is 2 minus I. And this expression is nothing but the Z. We started off with Z, right? So Z bar got ended up with Z. Therefore, the particular expression is real. So this is how we have to do this sum, and this is a very important 5-mark sum. In today's class, we have completed the exercise 2.4 and some of the example sums also. In tomorrow's class, I mean the next class, we'll be continuing with the next exercise and its related concepts. Thank you, children.